It's easier than ever to add authentication and authorization to your MCP servers with WorkOS AuthKit. This is part two of a two-part series around OAuth in MCP. If you missed the first video, you can check it out up here. After doing that initial setup, you'll be ready to go for this video on authorization using WorkOS RBAC. Let's get into it. On screen now is the repository for my Cloudflare MCP server authenticated with WorkOS AuthKit. If we jump down here, we see that there's a hidden feature implemented. To show authorization working, we can add an image generation permission inside of the WorkOS admin and get access to an image generation tool. So let's go to the WorkOS dashboard and set up this image generation permission. In the WorkOS dashboard, there is a prerequisite. We need to have an organization. Every account comes with a test organization, which we can use for this demonstration purpose, and a user, which is assigned to that test organization. This is the user that I'll be authenticating with. From there, jump to roles and permissions, create a new permission. We'll name this generate images, and then use that unique key that's already set up in this MCP server. Description is optional, so we'll leave it blank for now. And here is our new permission. Now in roles, we wanna add that permission to a role. I'm seeing image generation as a more premium feature, so I'll add a subscriber role to make sure that people are paying for this feature. Lowercase subscriber as the slug is great. And we'll add our image generation permission to this role. And now back in my organization, I want to find my user and edit their role from member to subscriber. This new subscriber role gives them the image generation permission. Cloudflare's Worker AI LLM Playground is where we can test our MCP server by providing the URL to our MCP server and connecting. Now, if you have a cached connection, you may need to clear this and reconnect to go through the full WorkOS AuthKit sign-in flow. Now that we're authenticated, we see two tools that we're authorized to use. Add is available to anyone, and generate image is only available to our subscriber permission. Now, using this image generation tool, we can ask for image generation. Create an image of a cute bulldog. Here, the MCP server uses the tool generate image to create this cute picture of a little bulldog. And the assistant says, the function call to generate an image of a cute bulldog is made with the generate image function using the prompt a cute bulldog and the default number of 8 steps. Now, you probably didn't watch this video just to see cute bulldogs, so let's take a quick look at the code. In our Git repository, we can go to source and index, where we find the definition of our MCP server. And in it, we find two tools. This is the add tool that's available to everyone. And just below it is conditional or provisional access to the generate image tool. This is only available if the WorkOS permissions objects includes the image generate permission. And obviously here you can find the rest of the default prompt. So that's it. It is remarkably easy to take your MCP server and quickly add RBAC style roles and permissions to make sure that only the right customers get the right access to the right tools. If you're interested in learning more about MCP, you might like to join us for our MCP night down in San Francisco at the Exploratorium. You can sign up for an invite right now. Now, if you're interested in more MCP stuff and just want to subscribe to the channel, you can do that too. I'm Chantastic. See you in the next one. Bye.